AM weekend edition of the news on Equinox Television, live from our headquarters in Cameroon's economic capital, Douala, and individuals opening fire on the convoy of the Southwest Governor Benao Kalia-Bilai. His convoy came under attack twice while he was on his way to Libya alone for the installation of senior division officer Tambu Kaya. As we shall be giving you details in this newscast with our correspondent in the Southwest region, Derek Jatton. Also in this newscast, we shall take you to Mostolidi, one of the communities in Soweto, South Africa, under chronic underdevelopment as a result of the apartheid that rocked that country for several years. We shall be giving you details in this newscast with a special envoy to South Africa, Staff Lady Mimi Mefu. Those were top news. Thanks for joining us on this edition of the news on Equinox Television. The convoy of the governor of the Southwest region of Cameroon, Benao Kalia-Bilai, came under attack two times on the Chang Menji Road, linking two regions, the West and Southwest regions of the country. His convoy was attacked by unidentified armed individuals while he was on the way to Libya for the installation of senior division officer Tambu Kaya, as you recently appointed by the President of the Republic, Paul Biya. And a Southwest correspondent, Derek Jato, reports that the armed individuals opened fire on the governor, Benao Kalia-Bilai. He now takes us through the perilous journey in this report.
After spending over 2 hours at the residence of the senior divisional officer for Memra Division in the West Region of Cameroon, Southwest Governor Mr. Benao Kalia-Bilai is heading to the Libya Division for the installation of the new senior divisional officer for that division. Security is top on the agenda, and the Rapid Intervention Battalion B is leading the convoy. Just after Alo, the Southwest Governor's convoy is halted for the combat with the security forces to scan the environment, and everywhere was seemingly quiet. But into Liro village, the atmosphere was different.
It's serious for that attack now. Well, under attack, that's bullet you're getting in the background. We have been attacked here.
We are just into Liro now. Governor Benao Kalia-Bilai of the Southwest region came under attack. From the bushes, the unidentified armed men rained down bullets on the Southwest governor's convoy from the surrounding forested hills. Security forces responded immediately, and the gun battle lasted for some few minutes.
We are out of
way to Menji, chief town of the Bialem Division. The town of Menji is not the same again. Menji is now having a picture of a war zone. At the senior divisional officer's office, marks of the 22nd March attack on Mr. Ongito Zakari, the then senior divisional officer for the BLM division, was very visible. His official car was heavily chopped by bullets from the unidentified armed men. Judging from the damages, some military sources revealed that those who must have inflicted such damages are heavily sophisticated. It was during this attack that a delegate was killed and Mr. Ongito Zakari seriously wounded.
This is your new senior divisional officer, Mr. Senior Divisional Officer Eta Ashu Mbokaya. Take command.
After the intervention of Mr. Eta Bukaya Ashu as the senior divisional officer for the BLM division, the Southwest governor, Mr. Bernardo Kalia Bilal's convoy, is heading back to Boya via the West region. I'm just ascending Lewo Village again. Southwest government came under a more serious attack that lasted longer than the previous.
The second time, it was in this place where we were going that this convoy was attacked. Same in that same spot in the war, the convoy again has been attacked. We are getting this time.
Situation has continued worsening on the ground as far as the Anglophone crisis is concerned, since it escalated more than a year. So the Cameroon is stepping up the fight against improvised explosive devices being used by terrorists from Boko Haram, the Nigerian terrorist sect in the far north region of the country. The United States and France are helping to boost the capacity of officers of the military engineering unit in the fight against such threats, and it is within this context that some 25 officers of the military engineering unit just ran it up a training course here in the economy capital Douala. We have details in this report.
They have been trained by experts from the U.S. Army Africa for 5 weeks and by French soldiers from Gabon for 2 weeks. During the 7-week training at the military engineering unit base in Cameroon's economic capital, Douala, these officers of the military engineering unit were equipped with higher technical know-how in the fight against improvised explosive devices. The training, which started 4 years ago, has upgraded their capacity in the fight against improvised explosive devices, which the Nigerian terrorist sect Boko Haram began using in the far north region of Cameroon in 2014.
Sergeant Ogwenu Elvis, as people can see, I'm from the Federation that we were well trained in a such way that we can know how to intervene in some improvised explosive devices. We are prepared or fit to fight against any improvised devices that is being placed anywhere. We can detect them, define them, and we take them, even destroy them.
All of them, 25, successfully went through the training, but one could not receive his end of course attestation at the end of course ceremony because of ill health.
security forces have arrested two individuals with a stolen vehicle here in the economic capital Douala. The individuals were intercepted in Nyala, and the pickup truck was stolen in the West Regional Chieftain. But for some details in this report compiled by Innocent Aze.
Toyota pickup vehicle with matriculation plate number CE299BF, stolen in Bavusam West Region Thursday night, was recovered Friday morning around Nyala neighborhood in Douala by elements of Zemi number 2, led by the commissioner, Mefili Roger. The two hoodlums were apprehended, grazed to a global positioning system installed in the car. By the time of their arrest, they were in possession of plate numbers of another car, its driving license, and fuel cards. They were also in possession of keys of several vehicles. But the culprits claim they picked them in a vehicle. An annoying justification to the Zemi commander. This other says he was invited by his partner in crime. He swears to abstain from such crimes. To the prime suspect, Elvis, it is his first time to steal a vehicle. He was tempted when he saw no one in the car.
Quand j'ai passé, j'ai vu la voiture, il a béni, qui vient me porter un pardon à la vie.
The open vehicle attracted him. They are now under custody at Jamie number 2, Bonanjo, Douala, awaiting trial.
Workers of the Banana and Plantain Research Center in Jombe in the Mongo Division, Littoral Region of the Republic of Cameroon, continue with their strike action. Over 10 months of unpaid salaries and activities have been grounded at the center. The workers have vowed not to return to work until they get favorable answers to their plight. Once more, Innocent Aze has the details.
Workers of the African Center for Research on Banana and Plantain, Karba, Njombe, Mungu Division of the Littoral Region, still observe their strike action. They remind management with messages on placards. We are at 10 months unpaid salaries. President Paul Biya, save us. They believe the Minister of Scientific Research and Innovation has taken them hostage.
We don't remain so, no, not money.
The striking workers have abandoned work. Young banana and plantains being nursed die. The plantation goes wild. No one to clear the bushes and take care of the bananas and plantains. Workers say they prefer working with foreign personnel scared away by Cameroonian authorities.
Foreigners, they can't work. They want to do follow. I say they follow as the statute they talk. They know they want them foreigners at the book.
Those occupying posts of responsibilities are Cameroonians who work at their detriment.
Man will control money, not Cameroonian. All these are not Cameroonian. No one foreigner not do again.
It's a mark affair at the verge of absolute control by one nation, Cameroon.
No country no agree to give money because all Cameroonian, they don't take a shit on top, seen at their teeth.
Workers of Karaba have remained adamant to their stance. No payment of 10 months salary is open, no resumption of duties.
In the report coming up next, we take you to Bilongedo, a neighborhood in the Douala 3 subdivision where inhabitants are living under the permanent risk of diseases, and this is because of the poor hygienic conditions in that part of Cameroon's economic capital Douala. Reporter Rabiatu Aliyu was there and she brought back this report.
This is what renders inhabitants of Bilongedo neighborhood in Douala, Littoral Region of Cameroon, in a state of discomfort. Some inhabitants even fall sick due to this sinking river.
Ben, je ne sais pas, au niveau d'ici, comme nous sommes les habitués, peut-être quelque part, ça rend les autres enfants malades.
Domestic and industrial waste dumped in the river to be transported, but end up blocking the passage.
Les gens ont mis les toilettes, les gens ont fait les selles, ça tombe un peu dedans.
Consequently, the accumulated waste decay intensifies the air with unpleasant smell.
D'autres meurent qu'à l'intérieur, bon là, c'est grave.
Many have drowned in the contaminated river, which has now become a pool.
Il y a les odeurs. Ne laisse pas les gens.
According to the inhabitants of Bilongedo neighborhood in Douala, River Dende, commonly known as Fleuve Noir in French, was initially clear in color. Its color changed with time since waste disposal are dumped in sight.
On crie haut et fort. Personne ne l'entend.
Inhabitants in the locality have complained to authorities about the unpleasant environment to no avail. They are now forced to continue to adapt to the disgusting living conditions.
While several neighborhoods in Cameroon's economic capital dwell and many parts of the country are in horrible conditions that favor the spread of diseases like malaria, officials of public health are paradoxically stepping up the fight against malaria, concentrating on other areas, notably sensitization on the use of mosquito nets and, of course, on other measures taken by a government against the spread of malaria. And this was the purpose of a 10-kilometer walk that was organized here in the economic capital Douala today within the context of the World Day for the fight against malaria. Details in this report.
Malaria remains one of the major health problems in Cameroon. However, with regards to the drop in the prevalence rate from 40 to 18%, medical officials say malaria is gradually being pushed back.
Malaria is reducing, although we have the prevalence of about 18% of the population who is still carrying that disease, that is reducing.
And the fight against malaria continues. It was the purpose of this 10-kilometer walk, spearheaded by Micro Governor Samuel Didier Vahadiboa through some major streets of Douala Saturday within the context of the World Day for the fight against malaria.
The delegates in charge of health tell us that we have to use those nets to fight against malaria. And we want all the population of Douala to be involved in this fighting. You know, we are a place where we have many mosquitoes. There are more than people that are living in Douala.
This type of activity helps us to intensify our sensitization towards populations, to let them know what are the main strategies put in place by the government. For instance, using of mosquito nets and the treatment of small child less than 5 years, and prevention towards pregnant women with this latent malady, très compliqué.
Because of the complicated nature of malaria, Dr. Monty Antoine, permanent secretary of the Coalition of the Business World Against Malaria, AIDS or Tuberculosis, says the fight must be permanent.
I told you in the headlines that will take you to Mostualedi, a neighborhood in Soweto, South Africa. It is one of the areas in the country still in chronic underdevelopment as a result of apartheid, even though the apartheid had been abolished more than three decades ago. The locality and many other parts of the country are still in deplorable conditions. Details with a special envoy to South Africa. Staff lady, meeting before.
This stone stationed by the roadside, painted in white, yellow, green and red colors, welcomed us to Elias Mosualedi, one of the poorest communities in Soweto, South Africa. Situated in the eastern part of Orlando, the area has remained the same since the abolition of apartheid in 1991. Arts and Art. Houses constructed with worn-out billboards and other makeshift materials. The rate of unemployment here is extremely high, with poor standard of living the order of the day.
So there's a main stone.
As we arrived the area, we were welcomed by this captain of the neighborhood. He took time to explain the challenges of the close to 30,000 people living in this community.
This is my north, my south, my east, my west. On the south, we have many villages. Education is what we need.
In Miswalidi, electricity is absent. The people only use stoves and generators to carry out their daily chores. They believe that their plight is no longer a priority to the government.
We don't have electricity, but we have just electricity heating right now. We use generators.
Education here is luxury. Only few parents can afford to pay for their children's fees, but then they have to cover long distances, like 3 to 6 kilometers, before arriving at the school campuses.
What you're seeing is a house that can six people can live, or eight more people. And it's 3 rooms, as you can see. This is a bedroom, sitting room, that's a kitchen, and a standing room.
Yeah. Between 6 to 8 people live and spend the night in a room like this one, where only a single bed is available.
It's the most key thing, the kitchen.